Hello, my name is Todd Monroe, and today I'm going to show you how to move your single WordPress installs over to a multi-user WordPress install. The new WordPress 3.0 has the multi-user integrated into it, so this makes things a little bit easier. Two things I will assume that you have done is install your WordPress multi-user on a new host, and as well that you've upgraded all your old installs, your single WordPress installs, to the latest version of WordPress as well. Okay, so we're going to just start by going to our old host that has our old installs on it. And two things we need from this old host are the files as well as the database. So if you go to myphpmin on your old host and look for your we're going to do this one right here, your old installs. The only tables that we need are from the comment metadata down to the term taxonomy. We don't concern ourselves with user meta or just the user table. So we're going to go ahead and export those tables. Okay. And just save them to your desktop. And we're also going to grab some files. Now, depending on what your client has done, they probably have installed in template, as well as they'll have some posts and possibly images and files as well. So we'll grab the template. And that's contained in the WordPress content, everything we need. Themes. I believe it's this one right here. We'll just compress that. Compress the file. Close that. And just download that to your computer. As well as we're going to need the whatever they've uploaded into their uploads folder. So just compress that as well. And that take that zip file down to your computer. Okay, that's all we needed from our old host. So we can close that down. And we'll go to new WordPress 3.0 multi-user install. And the first thing we have to do is set up a website for them, a subdomain off on this main website here. So you'll have your super admin if you've installed the multi-user function in the WordPress 3.0. I'm going to create a new site. And you have two options here when you've set up your install is to either have subdomains or subfolders. I'm going to be domain mapping over all my clients, so I just chose subfolders as an option. Depends on if you have wildcard domains on your web host or not. So we'll just do this. So this is one of my clients that I'm going to be setting up. If you've told them about it this already, you can send them their put their admin email in here, and it'll send them a message to that you're setting up their new website, or you can just put yours in. And then do the user afterwards. Depends on how you want to do it. You can put the user in first or use the user in afterwards. Okay, so what we're concerned here is our website ID. Each website's going to have its own individual number, and the one I just created here is number 9. So just remember this number. Number 9 is the website that we've just created. Okay, so now we're going to have to go to our new web host, and we're going to have to go into the database, and I'll just show you what that looks like. my PHP admin and the database. So like I said, each WordPress install will have its own number, and you can see each one has a number. So number 9 is the one we're concerned with here. You'll see from here, comment meta, it goes down to term taxonomy. We don't even have the user or user metadata. That's not in here, right in the individual websites. Okay, so what we're going to do, just open your old database table in your favorite editor. Mine's Notepad++. If you're not familiar with databases, don't worry too much. There's only one thing to worry about here is we have to change this WP underscore to the include the website ID number. The easiest way to do that is find and replace. So find what? We're looking for WP underscore. And my new install actually changed the WP to a MUWP at the beginning, so I'm going to have to change mine to MUWP underscore site 9 underscore, and we'll just replace all those. And it says 78 occurrences were replaced. That's great. And we'll just close that down, and we'll save this. And you can see here that they've been changed, MUWP underscore 9. So we're going to have to import these tables. But we have these tables here first. You can either erase them directly, or I suggest making a backup of your whole database, just on the safe side, since you're playing around with this a little bit. You can rename these tables here first to maybe like old underscore WordPress 9 and just change the names of all these, or you can just delete them if you're living on the edge. And install the new ones. Just make sure you don't go any further than that. And we're going to drop those. Yes. And then what we want to do is just import the old database that we changed. I believe that's it. Yes, it is. Open. And once that's been uploaded, we should see here they are. They've been replaced right in the right spot there. So since we did the database first, this means that our website is showing a blank page now. So if we go to our Rifkind website, we're just going to get a blank page if we visit the site. Oops, sorry. One more thing we have to do here is it's pointing to the old website. Since we took that data in, we're going to go in the site info here. We're going to want to update the site URL and home as well. So just check that box, because what we want now is go to nimbleize.ca/Rifkind the new one. So we'll just update those options. And you can see now that your URL's changed. So when you visit the site, we should have our website pretty much set up. I actually already had the thematic theme installed on this website, so it's already realizing that theme is the one to use. The information, I'm not sure how much information they've put in here, but anyway, the HTML is there, so we still have to actually upload all the files and images to the new host as well. So we'll do that. And you'll notice one more thing. Nope, it's not here. Don't worry about it. Certain websites, you'll notice the if they use the admin name and stuff like that, it'll be your name, and you'll have to go in and change all that if you didn't set up the user, first of all. So on the new host, we're going to just go to the file manager. Now on the old host, all the folders or all the files were in the directory of uploads. Things are still in the WP content on the new multi-user site, but instead of being in the uploads for your sub-sites, it's under the blogs directory. So just open your blogs directory. If the number 9, as I need, isn't created yet, just do new folder. Number 9, it's only the number, that's all you need, is a number, and we're going to open that up. We need a folder called files as well, so we're just going to call that files. Oops. And inside of files, we can upload our old files. Makes sense, doesn't it? And so I'm looking for 2010. Oops, just passed it. Nope, 2010-2, because I've done this a couple times today. Okay, well that's uploading. We'll just go back to our file manager and reload. See if our zip file's there. Yep. So we'll extract it, and we're going to have to change the name as well. Oh, no, we don't have to. Good. And delete that. And we'll just take a look inside there. If they actually did have anything, yep, there's a whole bunch of stuff in there. So that's good, they'll be happy. All right, so that's pretty much all you need to do to bring your website over. All that is left for us to do is to do the domain mapping, which involves going to the domain registrar, changing the DNS records over to your new host, and then picking up through the website WordPress domain mapping administration. One thing to remember when you do that is to make sure that you do not use it as an add-on, but use it as a parked domain. One last thing I forgot to do with this this website was I did not set the new user first of all. I plan to do it in the end once I've done everything. Do not use users here. Do not add the new website user in your super admin because you're adding a user to your root site. You want to be in the person's website and add user into their user area here. So you just do add new, and you'd put the person's name and email and send them a confirmation. And then they would know that their new site is ready to go, and the last thing would be to do the domain mapping. Once your registrar and everything has changed over your DNS records, you could just go into domain mapping, make sure it's a parked domain on your new one, and just it's not domain mapping, just want to hit the domains here. You just make sure you put in the site ID, which would be number 9, and the domain name that you just pointed over to your website. You can search the domains as well. That's fine. All right. Well, that's about it. So enjoy your new WordPress 3.0 install. My name is Todd Monroe again, and have a good day. Bye-bye.